morning, children. This is Mrs. Pramila Rao, your English teacher. Today, I'll give you an introduction to the second chapter of Flamingo, Lost Spring, Stories of Stolen Childhood. It's chapter written by Anis Jung. In this chapter, the writer Anis Jung analyzes the grinding poverty and traditions which condemn these children to a life of exploitation. First of all, we'll discuss about the title of this chapter. Why is this chapter titled Lost Spring, Stories of Stolen Childhood? Spring, as you know, is the most beautiful season amongst all the seasons. And in the same way, childhood, the time which you are enjoying now, is the most beautiful period in a person's life. In this chapter, we have two stories. The first one is, Sometimes I Find a Rupee in the Garbage. The title of the first story is, Sometimes I Find a Rupee in the Garbage. This story is of Saheb-e-Alam. He is the protagonist of this story, but he is a rag picker. And the second story is, I Want to Drive a Car. The title of the second story is, I Want to Drive a Car, where the protagonist Mukesh is a child who is engaged in making bangles like any other child of Firozabad. These two stories taken together depict the plight of street children forced into labor in life and denied the opportunity of schooling. Children, you need to really thank God for giving you this wonderful opportunity of studying in the best school of Rewa. These poor children, so many, n number of children are there in the world, innumerable number of children who are denied the opportunity of schooling, and their childhood has been stolen from them because of poverty. The author Anis Jung comes across a group of barefooted rag pickers scrounging or looking for gold in the garbage heap. We are now discussing the first story. The author Anis Jung, in a neighborhood, comes across a group of barefooted rag pickers. They were scrounging or looking for something, means might be gold in the garbage heap. The author asks Saheb, why are you doing this? And Saheb answers, I have nothing else to do. Immediately comes another question, why don't you go to school? And they reply, there are no schools in my neighborhood. That was Saheb's reply for that. And half joking, the author asked once again, would you join if I start a school? Saheb smiled broadly and said, yes. After a few days, when Saheb met the author, he rushed to her asking if the school was ready. The author felt embarrassed because she actually made a promise that was not meant. And promises like this abound in every corner of his bleak world. And she asked him, what's your name? He said, my name is Saheb-e-Alam. You know what's the meaning of Saheb-e-Alam? It means the Lord of the universe. Thank God he doesn't know the meaning of it. The Lord of the universe, and scrounging in the garbage heaps. And he roams the street barefoot with other rag pickers. And I hope you are ready with the notebooks. We'll discuss the first question. Who was Saheb and what was he doing and why? And you know, means who was Saheb? He was a boy. He was scrounging in the garbage dumps. And he had left his home in Dhaka, Bangladesh. And had come to the big city near Delhi, on the periphery of Delhi, exactly speaking Simapuri, in search of a living. And he has nothing else to do but picking rags. Okay, you can write the first question. Who was Saheb and what was he doing and why? And where was he coming from? Or where had he come from? I think you can write the answer now. Saheb was a young boy of school going age. He was looking for gold in the garbage dumps in the big city. He had left his home in Dhaka, Bangladesh, which was destroyed in a storm. And now the second question. Promises like mine abound in every corner of this bleak world. What promise does the author recall? In what context was it made? A student, note down the answer. The author asked Saheb about going to school. Saheb explained that there was no school in his neighborhood. He promised to go to school when they built one. The author, half joking, asked whether he would come in the school in case she started one. Saheb smiled broadly and agreed to come. After a few days, he ran up to the author and asked if the school was ready. The author really felt embarrassed because even though she had made a promise, she did not actually mean that. Clear? We'll move to the next paragraph tomorrow.